Thank you, sir, for that enlightening session. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please join your hands together to welcome Dr. Mohanaya, Chief General Manager of NABARD. Today, Mr. Mohanaya will share with us his rich and varied experience on the role of IT professionals in the farm ecosystem. He is the retired Chief General Manager of NABARD. Trained as an economist, Mr. Mohanaya held important positions throughout his career in different organizations. He led two regional offices of NABARD, West Bengal 2007 to 2010 and Andhra Pradesh 2010 to 2012 to the top slot among all the major regional offices of NABARD consecutively. He holds a postgraduate in economics from Osmania University, and he started his career as a branch manager in Nagarjuna Grameena Bank in Khammam district of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you, sir. We welcome you to this.
Chief guest of the today's seminar and the main speaker, Sri Subhash Palekarji, Sri Ravindar Rao Garu, Chairman of Telangana State Cooperative Bank, who is leading the cooperative institutions from the front, Sri Chandrasekharji, Advisor of Gram Bharati, Sri Stambadi Reddy Garu, President of the Grama Bharati Telangana, friends from the IT sector, other professionals, invitees, media friends, good morning to all of you. In fact, I was surprised with the introduction. I thought I was supposed to introduce people, so she was introducing me, but that is part of the history. What we need to do is make the history now here onwards. Friends, either Subhash Palekarji or the subject matter of the today's seminar need no introduction to you, those who have already read the literature, visited the farmers, and detailed exposition by Sri Chandrasekharji, so that makes my job very easy. But I thought I will try to give a conceptualize the thing, means why the contexting, why this seminar was required, what is the context, and what we need to achieve in these 2 days, how do we move forward. I think some contextualization, I'll try to do that. It is day in and day out, you are seeing in the media, both print and electronic media, how the farmer who is providing food for 1.25 billion Indians 3 times a day is forced to commit suicide. Nothing can be more shameful for a civic society than this, I feel. In fact, the official statistics itself say more than 3.5 lakh farmers have committed in the last one decade or so. Palekarji doesn't even agree with that. He says at least 7 lakh people have committed suicide. It's a serious matter for a country like ours with such a huge population, which on the brink of, because every time we see if there is a natural calamity, prices go up, or if there is some kind of disturbance, prices go up, it becomes very difficult to sustain. So agriculture is passing through such a critical phase. Quite a few reasons could be there for that. Cost of the inputs are going up. The technology itself, what we have inherited from the Green Revolution, so-called Green Revolution, it's not paying dividends now. Maybe initially we had, it has helped the country to get kind of sufficiency that we needed at that part of time. But today it doesn't support the requirements of the day. Even today we are importing huge stocks of pulses, oils, and other essential things. So we haven't achieved the self-sufficiency that we have been talking of, which Palekarji will explain you in detail. So this is one context. And the technology that we have been using for the last 3 decades or so has adversely affected the natural resources. our lands are no longer able to sustain the crops. Their fertility has gone down. Waters have been contaminated totally. In fact, you do not get to drink any natural water now. It's all bottled water now we are used to. And you have seen the impact on the climate change. This year, we are all experiencing that there are no adequate rains. Either you have excess rains or you don't have rains. So this technology that we have been using for the last 3 decades has impacted so adversely on our ecosystem. And this is one of the things which is forcing people to migrate from agriculture to other sectors, from rural areas to urban areas. And nowadays, agriculture has become a profession where, you know, if you cannot do anywhere else, you still remain in agriculture. So that kind of situation has come. And many times people even say that farmers are finding it difficult to even find brides in the villages. You cannot get your farmer son married. So the farmers also do not want their children to continue in the agriculture field. So to that situation, the country has come, which is quite a serious issue. Is there any alternative from this? Is there any ray of hope for us? I think that's where Sri Subhash Palekarji becomes relevant. And he has shown a ray of hope, how we can reverse the entire trend and get back to the original status of the country, original status of the agriculture as such, which was sustaining the huge population of the country for the thousands of years. So what we have lost in the last couple of decades needs to be undone, and then we go back to the nature. That's where the zero budget natural farming becomes important. That's where the Palekarji becomes important for all of us. Now the issue still, raised many a times. By adopting this technology, can we ensure the food security? That is one main issue scientists or anybody would question. We welcome Sri Jalpath Rao Garu, the former registrar of Acharya NG Ranga Agriculture University. Welcome, sir. So in that context, even the food security issue is raised. If we adopt this technology, can we ensure that food production will not be affected? We'll be in a position to feed the growing population, burgeoning population. So for that, Palekarji has a clear answer, and it has been experienced by the farmers, which Chandrasekharji has mentioned, and where you have visited some of the farmers. The productivity and the production does not come down, but it actually goes up by adopting the zero budget. So we know what is the solution. We also know how it has to be taken forward, but still it has not become the policy of the government. It is still a people's movement, a farmer's movement. But if it has to be scaled up, if it has to be have a scale, then there is a need to take it as a policy of the government, and for which several people are making attempts. Hopefully it will be done sometime sooner than later. Now the 2 days conference that we have, which Chandrasekharji has explained, we have 4 clear objectives for this conference. The first thing is generate awareness about the zero budget natural farming amongst the professionals who are the, you know, opinion makers, those who matter in the society. So some of you have gone to the villages, have seen the, interacted with the farmers, but some of you are coming afresh to the program. So it will be an attempt to create awareness about the technology, create awareness about the usefulness of this technology and how it is going to impact our lives. So that is first part of it. Second thing which Chandrasekharji has mentioned, how do we leverage your knowledge, your information technology knowledge, for spreading the message of the zero budget natural farming among the community at large? The country is so big, 6 lakh plus villages and so many farmers. How do we reach this message to them? So how do we leverage your knowledge, your technology for spreading this message? That is the second objective of the seminar. Third one, which becomes very important for us, is the food that we are eating today. We do not know about its quality. We do not know, because many of our food items, if they are exported to Europe or America, will be rejected because of the pesticides, because of the overuse of fertilizer. The remnants in these food grains do not, in fact, that is not edible stuff as such. So how do we generate awareness amongst ourselves, the quality of the food, and how do we look out for the improve our health because of the food? In fact, Palekarji many times says, food is a medicine. It is not a food, but it is a medicine. So to cure ourselves, to make ourselves healthy, we need to have healthy food. So creating awareness about that issue also is one of the main objective of this seminar. The fourth one is, in fact, a very important, taking a decisive step towards reaching out to the large number of people. So this two-day seminar, with the help of all of you, if you can reach out to large number of people, that is a good step that we'd have taken forward. They say in the extension, they say lab to land, but now in the food context, we have to say from field to the dining table. So how do we reach good food to the dining table? So that should be facilitated by this two-day seminar. So kind of networking, which Chandrasekharji was mentioning. So how do we create a market? In fact, some of the farmers, when we interact, they say the outlets we require for marketing these products. So can we have kind of melas, kind of exhibitions frequently in different places so that the farmers get to directly reach out to the customers instead of going through the middlemen? Because many times we see the farmer gets hardly 15% to 20% of the consumer, what consumer pays. So can we bridge that gap? We'll see that farmers get a major chunk of the what consumer pays. So if we can bridge a kind of link between the producers and the consumers, so that will be one attempt what we will be making from this seminar. So you have all determined to participate in this, make use of the full 2 days session which Palekarji will be taking, and the in-depth knowledge that he has on the issue and the commitment with which he offers the subject, I think you should make full use of it. I would like to end on a simple comparison. Our society, we all have become Kalidasas. You know what Kalidasa has done? So he was cutting the branch on which he was sitting. Today we are exactly in the same position where we are killing the nature which supports us. We are cutting the nature which supports us. So Kalidasa was saved by Ma Kali, and we will be saved by Subhash Palekarji. All the best. Thank you.